Welcome guys. Today we are going to look at how to open a new project in PyCharm. We are using the Windows operating system. So we had already installed PyCharm and we are just going to start it from the start menu. And what you see here is your splash screen, which will appear in a few minutes and disappear in a few minutes. And it shows the windows or the window for new project open and get from VCS. So you can customize, you can add plugins, install plugins, and you can also refer to learn PyCharm if you want to know more about the PyCharm IDE integrated development environment. So we'll go to projects, and when you click on projects, new project, you're going to see we have the location that is highlighted, and you'll notice that when I change the name of the project, it changes also in the location text area. Then we have the environments which support VirtualEnv, PPEnv, and Anaconda, and it automatically creates a virtual environment which is shown by the location VENV. You can select the location whereby the base interpreter, if you have a different Python that you want to use, you can select the base interpreter. You can inherit global site packages, make them available to all projects. So these are among the settings that we have for a new project. So you can click next or create project. So it will create, the first step is that it creates the virtual environment. And of course, we have this tip of the day. You can choose not to view it. We're using the checkbox on the left bottom part. So it is creating the new project, and it has completed. So the project is named My First Project, and it has the folders as seen there. It only has the VENV for the virtual environment. And you'll notice at the bottom we have something that is showing progress by indexing, and we have the Python version on the bottom right and the name of the project. So inside the VENV we have the lib folder that contains the site packages folder that has the Python package index, the pip, and we have the scripts in Windows. If you want to activate a virtual environment, you refer to the scripts activate. In Windows, it's activate dot, you can use the activate.bat. Then we have the pip version, the pip executable files, and all that. And then we have the gitignore, the Python virtual environment configuration, pyenv.cfg. So we're going to look at file. We have the file menu, which you can use to refer to the settings. Under file, the settings menu. So the settings menu, once again, gives us liberty to adjust various things, but we're going to refer to project, my first project, which is the name of the project, and the Python interpreter. So currently it says that there's no interpreter. So you can also check the project structure, and you can add an interpreter or you can show all interpreters. So there's no interpreter that is loaded on PyCharm. This is because if you look at the bottom part, there is a background task, so it's it has to complete those tasks so that it can recognize the Python interpreter. You can also change the interpreter by clicking on that Python 3.9 on the bottom right, but we'll go back and look at it. Now you've seen that the Python interpreter has been loaded, and it also shows the path. You can also search for packages, available packages. If you want to install them, you can install them using the GUI, the GUI, for the user interface for PyCharm. But we are going to use a different method here. So you can also check the Python packages using the tab. In the bottom left, there's one of the tabs written Python packages that shows the Python package index, and also the available libraries for that you can use to download. Then we have the terminal. So the terminal by default loads Windows PowerShell. And You will notice that there's a difference here. We do not see the virtual environment, but it is loaded, just that it's not displaying. So if you click on this bottom arrow, you can select Git command prompt or Git bash. So you can try and see what the command prompt shows us. You notice that it shows us the virtual environment, the VE and V. If we switch back to PowerShell, it does not show us. Then we also have the Git bash, that is the bash for Git. This is because I've installed Git in my PC. So we'll just use the, for now we'll just use the PowerShell, or we can switch to the command prompt so that you can see the virtual environment in the in brackets. And we are going to type pip list that will show us the packages that are already installed, the libraries that are installed. We have three: pip, setup tools, and wheel, which are installed by default when you create a new virtual environment. So we can try and install a new package that's called Django. So it will install Django from the internet and the dependencies, the SGRF, PyTZ for time zones, SQL, parse. Yeah, so it may take some time depending on your machine. So right now it's installing the packages as it's shown in the command prompt. So you can install any packages that you wish if you are comfortable with them, and you can use them for various purposes. For example, Django is used for, it's a web framework, it's used for developing websites. So if I click pip list, you'll notice that we have additional packages from before. So that means that we have already installed Django. Yeah, sorry, you have to clear using CLS. Used to Linux, whereby we type clear. So we have the Django admin create project. This is just a command for creating a Django project. We're just testing if our Django is working. So we just create a new start project. And a dot indicating the project should be started in the created, the project folder will be created in the current directory. That's why we have a dot. And the name of the project is my project. So if we click enter, then it has created our project, and we should see the project in the folder above, in the same root folder as the VENV. So it's there, my project, the folder, which was not there, and it has a bunch of files, but we are not going to go into the details. So yeah, so it has created a number of files. This is the sgi.py. Yeah, so the settings file, and then you'll notice that there is a pop-up on the bottom right that you're using the Django framework. PyCharm Professional Edition has special support for it. So in a PyCharm Professional, you can be able to create a Django project, customize Django projects. So we'll test the server if it's running. We normally use not the start server, but run server. So I'll type run server, pymanage.py run server, and it has started a development server. So we'll just holding control, you can click on the link, and you'll see it should open our browser with a Django page. So it has opened the page. We open my browser, and this is a page. It's in my local host, port 8000. Yeah, so this indicates that we have installed Django successfully. So you can, you can notice that. Yeah, so we'll close our browser, and then we'll go back to our project and clear. Yeah, so we have been able to install, to create a project in PyCharm. You can create different projects as you wish, and it will automatically create for you the virtual environment. So we'll just exit PyCharm. Thank you for watching. Click share, like, and subscribe.